Hello, anatomy colleagues. This is Dr. Alsup, and you can't talk about joints without talking about arthritis. Well, I guess you could, but you shouldn't, because it is very important in terms of understanding some of the more typical pathologies associated with joints. So that's exactly what we're going to do. We're going to talk about the three main types of arthritis. Okay, rheumatism is any painful disorder of supporting structures of the body that is not caused by direct injury or infection. So when we're talking about supporting structures, this can include bones, muscles, tendons, and ligaments. Arthritis is going to be the form of rheumatism that is specifically going to affect the joints. That's why I said you can't talk joints without talking arthritis. And so this arthritis can cause joints to be painful, swollen, and or stiff. So there are three main types. The first we're going to talk about is osteoarthritis, or OA. And osteoarthritis is typically what people think about when they are thinking about arthritis. This is a degenerative or progressive and often irreversible deterioration of the articular cartilage. So this is a degenerative joint disease. And you can kind of see in this image that articular cartilage, which is on the ends of bones, is eventually worn away and lost with time. This arthritis is often thought of as the wear and tear arthritis. And this is a common cause for hip and knee replacement surgery in more severe cases. So think about that articular cartilage just over time with overuse can lead to osteoarthritis. And it can happen in many joints of the body. I mentioned hip and the knee. Some of the intervertebral joints can all have OA associated with it. Crystal arthritis, or gouty arthritis, or just plain gout as it's sometimes referred to, occurs when sodium urate crystals become deposited in and amongst the soft tissues of the joints, particularly the joints of the feet, especially of the first digit or the big toe. And you can really see kind of where you have some certain issues on this radiograph at that first metatarsophalangeal joint. And so what will happen is that the crystals that are in there will irritate, which can lead to inflammation, and erode the cartilage associated with these joints. So food and drink that is high in uric acid, like processed meats and alcohol, can lead to higher levels of this in the body, and this can lead to a higher risk of the crystals collecting in these areas, and so could be indicative of a gouty arthritis. Rheumatoid arthritis, or RA, is unique in the fact that it is an autoimmune disease in which the immune system will attack its own joint linings like the synovial membrane and cartilage. In fact, the primary symptom of RA is going to be inflammation of the synovial membrane, so that portion of the synovial joint. The joints in the hand tend to be the most affected or the most visibly affected in cases of rheumatoid arthritis, or RA. Okay, question and answer time. This one I hope is a little on the easier side, but let's see where we're at. So what is, so another name for crystal arthritis is what? So what is another name for crystal arthritis? And hopefully you've landed on A being the correct answer. You more commonly hear crystal arthritis actually referred to as gout or gouty arthritis. It's called crystal arthritis because of those sodium urate crystals that collect in the soft tissues of certain joints, but you could hear it certainly both ways, and I want you to be very familiar with both types of terms. Okay, so that will do us for our joints basics session, and I think we have a really nice foundation now to be able to discuss the details of specific joints as we move through the rest of the musculoskeletal portion of this course. Make sure to reach out to me with any questions you may have, and have a great rest of your day.